20 seconds away, standing by for physical separation.
Houston M station from Discovery, physical separation.
Undocking confirmed. Discovery weighs anchor from the International Space Station on the first leg of its journey home to planet Earth. Coming up on the first firing of the primary reaction control system jets to initiate a faster opening rate per the plan. Good stability, good control on Discovery.
Houston station on the big loop. We see you in greater than 100 seconds. We see ourselves in the stern block. Yeah, thrusters only just came up. Thrusters only just came up.
Station concurs.
And Discovery ISS. Station is in attitude control.
Discovery copy.
Mike Barrett and Tim Kopra exchanging information. Space station now resuming its own orientation.
At Houston station on the big loop, we saw ourselves going to Sudia mode. Thrusters only at about 107.
And we concur, Mike, thanks.
Discovery now 20 feet away from the International Space Station. Docking occurred right on time at 2:26 p.m. Central Time as the two craft flew 223 statute miles above western China near the Mongolian border. On the International Space Station is the shuttle Discovery, almost at a point 655 feet behind the International Space Station. In the upper left-hand corner of your screen is the Soyuz vehicle, one of the Soyuz spacecraft docked to the Russian segment of the International Space Station, and a good view of Discovery as Kevin Ford continues his radial fly-around of the complex. Right side of your screen, the Zvezda service module docked to the aft of Zvezda, the Progress 34 cargo craft. Nestled back into the rear of the cargo bay of Discovery, the Leonardo multipurpose logistics module that was filled with 2.5 tons of items no longer needed on the International Space Station after delivering almost 9 tons of science racks, assembly hardware, and other supplies for the Expedition 20 crew. Discovery 644 feet away from the station.
Discovery Houston on air to ground 2 for the radar data.
Go ahead, Houston.
Okay, we'll take spec 33, item 16, and then sometime after the plus R bar, we're hoping to take a look at the data and start taking in the setup for the SEP 1 bar.
Okay, yep, Pat's gonna give you item 16 right now, and then we'll stand by for your call on my next radar data.
segment of the International Space Station Kibo Science Lab. After a flawless fly around by pilot Kevin Ford, who soon will be transitioning to robotic arm operator, joining Pat Forrester and Jose Hernandez in about an hour and 15 minutes.